No, no one is forcing you to buy a new machine. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a collection of comments that I'm seeing often. It's all about Microsoft wanting to sell new computers and creating more e-waste. MS is working with PC manufacturers to force new hardware sales. All about forcing more expensive computers on us. My graveyard now has a perfectly good XP, Vista, and soon to be two Windows 10 computers. I'll be forced to buy a new computer when I already have four perfectly good computers. All of these are examples of comments relating to Windows 11's new hardware requirements. The perception is that if our existing computers aren't capable of running Windows 11, we're being forced to throw them away and buy new ones. Some even believe it's a conspiracy to sell more PCs. I'm going to sound a little frustrated here because no one is being forced to do anything. You do not have to get a new machine. You do not have to throw away your old machine, and there is no conspiracy. Here are some options. The most common recommendation I have when I see people complaining about this so-called forced purchase, don't get a new machine. In fact, don't change a thing. Stay with your existing machine running Windows 10. It'll keep running just fine. Here's a complete list, total list of absolutely everything that happens at Windows 10 end of support. Beginning on October 14th, 2025, Windows 10 will receive no further bug fixes, even if security related. That's it. That's the entire list. The machines will keep running. More importantly, security software, including Windows Defender, will continue to work and will continue to get updates. Other Microsoft software, including Office and potentially even other Microsoft utilities you see in Windows, will continue to work and they will continue to get updates. Non-Microsoft software will continue to work and continue to get updates. Software for your hardware, aka drivers, will also continue to work and continue to get updates. Now, how long that will all be true is an open question, of course, and it will vary depending on the specific hardware and the software involved. But it will most assuredly not come to an end on October 14. In fact, much of that may continue for years. Just ask folks who are still using Windows 8 and Windows 7. The only thing you might need to do is realize that, again, quoting, Windows 10 will receive no further bug fixes, even if security related, meaning that you'll need to be extra security conscious as you move forward. Do all the things you should be doing to keep yourself and your technology secure. Honestly, that's stuff you should be doing already anyway. So even that represents little, if any, change. All right, option number 1A, I'll call it, extended security updates. Microsoft has announced that you will be able to purchase 1 year of security updates to Windows 10 for $30. For people who purchase this ESU, it changes the statement, beginning October 14th, 2025, Windows 10 will receive no further bug fixes, even if security related, to this statement, beginning October 14, 2026, Windows 10 will receive no further bug fixes, even if security related. That's the only thing that changes. Everything else I discussed above remains the same. At this writing, Microsoft has not released any further details, and the ESU is not yet available for purchase. Option number 2, install Linux. This is probably the single most common comment made on the YouTube videos I've got out there discussing a variety of Microsoft and Windows 11 related issues. Switch to Linux. Many of those commenters either have or plan to switch to Linux when Windows 10's end of support date rolls around. It's a legitimate and very reasonable option. It just may not work for everyone. Oh, it'll definitely install and run on your existing Windows 10 machine, but you gotta realize it's not Windows. It's similar, but different user interface, something to get used to. Windows applications do not run on Linux. That means you will need to find Linux alternatives for the programs you rely on. And good support and documentation can be difficult to find. But depending on how you use your computer, Linux can most definitely be an option. No new machine required. Option number three, hacking Windows 11. So I'll be honest and tell you that I have mixed feelings on this one. There are techniques to install Windows 11 on hardware that technically doesn't support Windows 11. I've written articles on a couple of the techniques and they appear to work. The issue is that Microsoft, of course, doesn't like this. They have suggested that Windows 11 installed on hardware that isn't supported by Windows 11 will not receive updates. Right now, that doesn't seem to be the case. It's also unclear which updates they mean. Does it mean only Windows 11 updates? Updates for Windows Security and Windows Defender? Anything that's updated via Windows Update? We just don't know at this time. If this is a risk you're willing to take, honestly, I'd rather you stick with option number one. Sticking with Windows 10 seems less risky than not getting updates to an operating system that is still in active development. Option number four, switch hardware. Now, before I go into this, I want to be super, super clear. You do not have to buy new hardware. But you can, of course, choose to buy new hardware. There are generally three options that people consider at this point. One, get a Windows 11 compatible machine. While you'll have to get used to the changes in Windows 11, this is probably the easiest. Number two, get a Mac. There's much more to get used to, and in many ways, this is similar to switching to Linux, but Apple has a much higher reputation for quality in both its hardware and its software. They can be pricey, but for people tired of Microsoft's antics, it might very well be a reasonable option. Consider a Chromebook. The best way to describe a Chromebook is kind of like an Android phone masquerading as a laptop, but without the phone. If you primarily use your computer for web surfing and email, this can be a safe and less expensive alternative. Or, as I said, you could just keep using your Windows 10 machine, running Windows 10. My honest bottom line recommendation is that if you are at all concerned, choose option number one. Keep using Windows 10. Yeah, sure, someday, you might bump into a reason that could force the issue. Or someday you'll just get a new machine for other reasons with a future version of Windows pre-installed. But until then, there's no reason to panic. And there is certainly absolutely no reason to throw away a perfectly good piece of hardware if it's working well for you. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/179314. Remember, if you have a question, askleo.com/ask. Subscribe to my newsletter at askleo.com/newsletter. And support Ask Leo at askleo.com/patron. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.